For thousands of years, singer-song poets have not only been entertainers, but the voice of all societies. This concert will be a close-up, intimate encounter with these musical giants who tell the stories and the inspirations behind their songs. Appearing on this performance, Kenny Loggins, Richard Marx, Three Doors Down, plus special guest Diane Warren, and our rising star, Nathan Lee.
The siren's call, if you will, of pop music is that you can make a lot of money in a hurry if you follow the formulas that your record company will want you to follow. But what people really are after is somebody to say something fresh.
I want to start with a song from an album called Leap of Faith.
Where are all the dreams that we once had? This is the time to bring them back. What were the promises? Caught on the tips of our tongues. Do we forget or forgive? There's a whole other life waiting to be lived. One day we'll be brave enough to talk with conviction of the heart. And down your roads I'd walked alone, as if my feet were not my own. Such is the path I chose. Doors I have opened and closed. I'm tired of living this life, fooling myself, believing where I went. I've never given love with any conviction now. The heart
with the earth, with the sky, one with everything in life.
I believe we'll survive
if we only try.
How long must we all wait to change the world bound in chains that we live? Too many years of taking now. Isn't it time to stop somehow? If that's too angry to breathe, water our children can't drink. You've heard it hundreds of times. You say you're aware, believe and you care. Do you carry love? Where's your conviction?
Might as well. You know this one? Come on.
One with the earth, with the sky, one with everything in life. I believe it will start with conviction of
you. Now we got wet.
I'm enjoying, and have been for the last few years, really collaborating with writers who come from different schools of thought, because then it can take the melody somewhere else, and it can take the song to a whole new place. I mostly prefer writing as a collaboration. I've been collaborating all along, practically, certainly since Jimmy Messina. And I got very used to the kind of energy that a collaboration creates, and how in a good collaboration, the song can be more than either individual. As a writer, I'm still writing, I'm still recording. I like doing new material. I like expressing who I am and where I am at this stage of my life.
When I write a song, especially by myself, it comes first and foremost from the most selfish of places. It's just, you know, it's, you got something on your heart you got to get off your chest, you know. It's a very selfish exercise, at least for me, when I'm writing a song. And then what's really fascinating to me is how songs that you wrote from your own selfish perspective or selfish purposes become adopted by other people. That was never your intention. And in a song, in a case like the song I'm going to do, this is a song that I'm probably most identified with this song. And I have seen this song take on so many lives and be applied to so many other people's lives and situations, when in fact, I just missed her terribly. That's all it was, you know? So I'll do this song for you now. And if you guys know this song, please, whatever you do, don't join in, because you're going to ruin it.
I'll take
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
Wow. So now I have to sing one. It's first, just let me say it's an honor to be sitting up here with you guys, and I don't mean it. I mean it in the best way. I've been listening to you guys since
I was a kid.
Don't
say it. Don't do it. Don't go there.
I had to do it, man. I swear to God, and I do it. I mean it in the best way possible, man. And just loved you guys' music growing up, and it's an honor to sit here and sing with you tonight.
Thanks, Brad. Big fan of yours too.
Thank you, brother. This next song we're gonna do is a song off of a couple of records ago, actually. And this song just basically is about people with just being too dramatic. You know, I'm all about living your life with emotion, but just it's kind of about the drama kings and queens of the world. And this song's called My World. You're stuck on a chain. You're toe in the line. Seems like every time that you catch up, you only fall behind. And you're trapped inside this world you made yourself. But that's not the world I live in. This is not the life for me. My world's bigger than your problems, and it's bigger than me. Well, it's not the world I live in. This is not the life for me. My world's bigger than your problems, and it's bigger than me. There's always someone to blame. Everything that's going wrong is because of someone else. And you're trapped inside this world you made yourself. And that's not the world I live in. This is not the life for me. 'Cause my world's bigger than your problems, and it's bigger than me. But that's not the world I live in. This is not the life for me. So my world's bigger than your problems, and it's bigger than me. Because I'm on the outside, and I'm looking in. And that's not the world I live in. This is not the life for me. 'Cause my world's bigger than your problems, and it's bigger than me. Well, that's not the world I live in. This is not the life for me. 'Cause my world's bigger than your problems. That's not the world I live in. This is not the life for me. 'Cause my world's bigger than your problems, and it's bigger than me.
Nice job, dude.
The next song we're going to play is a song that I wrote for my baby. What this song is just saying is, you know, it doesn't matter what we have materially. It's just as long as I get to lay down by you at night, it's fine. And it's off our new record, and this song's called Your Arms Feel Like Home. I think I walked too close to love, and now I'm falling in. There's so many things this weary soul can take. Maybe you just call me by surprise. The first time that I looked into your eyes, and there's a life inside of me that I can feel again. And it's the only thing that takes me where I've never been. And I don't care if I lost everything that I have known. It don't matter where I lay my head tonight. Your arms feel like home. They feel like home. And this life ain't the fairy tale we both thought it'd be. I can see your smiling face as you're staring back at me. And I know we both see these changes now. And I know we both understand somehow. And there's a life inside of me that I can feel again. Takes me where I've never been. And I don't care if I lost everything that I have known. Cause it don't matter where I lay my head tonight. Your arms feel like home. Feel like home. So hold.
This is a song that I wrote with Mike McDonald. The opening line, there have been times in my life I've been wondering why. And then a line in the middle, you think that maybe it's over only if you want it to be. And I always consider those lines of lyric to be clues about what the song is. We started working on the lyric of that tune, and we thought the maybe it's over line was about a boy-girl thing, so we kept trying to force a relationship song onto it. And it was one of those rare circumstances where no matter how much we wrote to it, it never felt right. It never really fit with the melody. Michael and I reworked the song for an album I made in the Redwoods of Santa Cruz, California. This is the Redwoods version of a song called This Is It. Been times in my life I've been wondering why. Still somehow I believe we'd always survive. But now I'm not so sure you're waiting here. One good reason to try. Lord, one more can I say?
what's left to provide. You think that maybe it's over, only if you want it to be, yeah. No, I run, nowhere to hide, no time for wondering why. Here, the moment is now. I'm about to decide. Let him believe, leave him behind, but keep me near in your arms. I know whatever you do, I'm here by your side. You think that maybe it's over, only if you want it to be. For it seems life is a miracle. Stand up and fight. This is it. Make no mistake where you are. This is it. Going along for. Comes a day in every life. This is it. Till it's over and done, this is it. One way or another, well, this is it. I got to tell you, could nobody know. This is it. Which way it's moving, brother, which way it'll go. This is it. Somebody told me, been a fool all my life.
I won't speak for everybody up here, but I kind of, there's a kindred spirit that we all kind of share, which is the sense of writing a new song. It never loses its sense of wonder. I mean, after all these years of writing songs, I know, because I've been lucky enough to write songs with Kenny, and I know Brad a bit. When we write a new song, it's the most exciting thing ever. And I know when I travel internationally, for example, you know, you got to fill out your passport, and they always have occupation. I never, ever have put singer or juggler. Or I've always put songwriter to this day, because that's really the most important part of what I do. So I wanted to take this opportunity to do a brand new song for you guys tonight that that I just recorded and just wrote recently. So it's called Through My Veins. I
saw you in the window of a cafe I passed by. And though clearly my reflection, it was your face I recognized. And after all these years, I'm still right here where you left me. And I've been calling out, believing you would answer, but I'll try to
thank you very much. I never studied vocally ever, and I regret it, but I took music lessons, and I was already pretty serious by the time I was a sophomore in high school. I was writing songs, and I would go from school into the city of Chicago and take music classes at night. So I wanted to be prepared. It wasn't so much about trying to become a rock star, because when you're a little kid, you just want to be a rock star. But by the time I was in high school, my focus was, I knew that I wanted to have a career in music. That's all I knew. And so I figured, if I can do as many different things as I possibly can, then I'll probably benefit from that. And right around my senior year of high school, I get this call from Lionel Richie, who had heard a demo tape. To have this guy, who's on top of the music world,
call me up and say, man, I just heard this demo tape of yours and it's really good and you should think about coming to LA. And that was it when I was 18. My voice is the vehicle for the song, so that's kind of how it started. It wasn't like, I mean, I definitely think of myself as a songwriter who sings and not a singer who writes songs. I wrote this song a long time ago with my buddy Bruce Geich, who's here tonight. It's the first song I ever had out on the radio. Had Joe Walsh play the guitar solo on it. Couldn't go wrong.
Welcome to the big time. You're bound to be a star. And even if you don't go all the way, you know that you'll go far. This race is for rats. It can turn you upside down. Ain't no one you can count on in this sleazy little town. No, no. Lots of promises in the dark, but don't you open your heart, 'cause it don't mean nothing, the words that they say, yeah. It don't mean nothing, these games that people play, yeah. It don't mean nothing, no victim, no crime. It don't mean nothing till you shine it on dotted line, yeah, yeah. Oh. The director smiles as you walk in the door. He says, I love your work, babe, but you're just not what we're looking for. It's never what, but who it is, you know. Easy to get stuck in all that music roll snow. Take a good look around and you'll find people trying to mess with your mind. But it don't mean nothing, the words that they say, yeah. Don't mean nothing, these games that people play, yeah. Don't mean nothing, no victim, no crime. It don't mean nothing till you sign it on the dotted line.
Come on.
Hollywood can be so lonely, make you the winner of a losing fight. But the party is never over. Stars are always shining. Doesn't matter if it's day or night. Yeah, 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 yeah. Producer says, let me change a line or two, and a little bit of something can look awfully good to you. And you wanna scream, but you gotta keep it all inside, 'cause when you're trying to make a living, there ain't no such thing as pride. Oh no. Lots of promises in the dark, don't you open your heart.
Nah, totally just trying to be him.
But it don't mean nothing, the words that they say. It don't mean nothing, these games that people play. Yeah. Oh, it don't mean nothing, no victim, no crime. It don't mean nothing till you sign it on the dotted line. Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
You know, songs aren't born like babies. There's not a set time. They deliver when they're ready to deliver. And I think, well, Paul McCartney wrote Scrambled Eggs. Scrambled Eggs. Da-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. It's all he had. And it became Yesterday, but it became Yesterday way after the fact.
According to the Guinness Book of Records, Yesterday is the most recorded song of all time, with more than 3,000 recorded cover versions. It was originally recorded in 1965 by the Beatles for their album Help. According to Beatles biographers, Paul McCartney composed the entire melody one night in a dream. Upon waking, he hurried to a piano and taped the tune before it slipped his mind. He originally titled the work in progress Scrambled Eggs and reportedly finished the lyrics on his own despite repeated attempts to collaborate with his partner John Lennon. Reportedly, the other Beatles weren't so keen as Paul was. Feeling that it didn't fit their image, they didn't perform on the Beatles' own recording of the song. It was pitched to other artists, and with its first cover version by Matt Monro, quickly climbed into the top 10 UK singles chart. It wasn't until 11 years later, and after their breakup, that the Beatles released it as a UK single themselves. In addition to being the most recorded song of all time, Yesterday is also one of the half dozen most performed songs of all time, on radio and television. The British Songwriters and Publishers named it the most outstanding song of 1965, the year of its first release. Subsequently, it was voted best song of the 20th century in a BBC radio poll. Rolling Stone magazine's The 500 Greatest Songs of All Time list ranked it as number 13. If only every songwriter's dream could produce such a result.
All right, so this is the last song we're going to play tonight. Is actually the first single off our new record. And it's a song about resilience and always just kind of standing in defiance of the things in this world that try to bring you down or just altogether try to take you out. This song's called It's Not My Time.
Looking back at the beginning of this and how life was, just you and me and loving all of our friends, living life like an ocean. But now the current's only pulling me down, it's getting harder to breathe. It won't be too long and I'll be going under. Can you save me from this? 'Cause it's not my time. I'm not going, there's a fear in me, it's not showing. This could be the end of me and everything I know. Ooh, but I won't go. I look ahead to all the plans that we made and the dreams that we had. Well, I'm in a world that tries to take them away. Oh, but I'm taking them back. 'Cause all this time I'm just been too blind to understand what you matter to me. My friend, this life we live is not what we have, it's what we believe. And it's not my time. I'm not going. There's a fear in me, it's not showing. This could be the end of me and everything I know. But it's not my time. I'm not going. There's a will in me. And now I know that this could be the end of me and everything I know. Ooh,
Okay, here we go.
I'm alright. Nobody worry about me. You got to give me a fight. Why don't you just let me do what you like? Do it naturally. But if it's too easy, baby, they're gonna disagree. It's your life. In a little mystery, when it's nobody's business, everybody's game. You're gonna get your lady.
Mama, you make me feel good.
So Cinderella,
give it up and get to a job.
I'm alright. No mind where about me. You got to give me a fight. Why don't you just let me be?
I'm alright.
Right, alright.
No matter where I'm
at. You got to give me a fight. Why don't you just let me be? Who do you want? Who you gonna be today? Who is it really?
Really?
Make it up your mind.
Oh, you gotta love another man, yeah.
Pay attention to the magistrate. Got you in the mood. Listen to your heart. Don't get you late.
Mama, you made me feel good.
So Cinderella,
give it up and get you a job.
Ball, ball, ball.
I'm on
Richard
right.
Marks, ladies and gentlemen.
Nobody worry about me. You got to give me a fight. Why don't you just let me be? I'm on
right.
I'm on right.
Right, all right. Nobody
worry about me.
You got to give me a fight.
Why don't you just let me be? You just let me be. I'm alright.
I'm
legendary song poet, Diane Warren.
That's the things, I was so influenced by so many different things. I mean, the Beatles, huge influence. My mom and dad had all the cast albums of, you know, all the show tunes of like Man of La Mancha and stuff like that. And then just all the radio of the day and Motown. And I mean, it was such a diverse a group of influences influenced me. I mean, I got to hear everything. You know, and that's, I think that's kind of why I'm able to write in a lot of different styles. I still have that same fire I had when I was like 14. I mean, if you talk to anybody around here, I'm here at 8:30 every day. I mean, I can't wait to come to work and see what I'm gonna come up with. That fire is still the same as when I was a kid. I think the advice that I gave myself was like, I'm never stopping, I'm not gonna ever give up. I've been my own mentor more than other people. You know what I mean? Because a lot of the advice people gave me wasn't necessarily the best advice. You can't do, it's more like they said, you can't do this, you can't do that. You know, you can't be your own publisher, you can't, this person's gonna do your song, they write their own songs. This, you know, and what I've done is like go against all that. It's like, why? Well, why can't I be my own publisher? Why can't I play something for Steven Tyler or Lenny Kravitz or whoever? You know, whatever, they write their own songs, but what if I have something that they like and they wanna make their own, you know? So, you know what I mean? So it's like, so a lot of the advice I've been given isn't necessarily advice I'd follow, so I'm always kind of good, like, I kind of like when someone says you can't do something. It's like, really? You know, I'm it's like the rebel in me. That's the part that hasn't grown up. So it's like, really, you tell me I can't do it. Okay, I'm gonna do it then. You know, just to prove I can. You know, it's kind of fun. Don't do it unless you die without doing it. Whether it's writing a song or anything. Especially something this tough. It ain't easy.
This week's rising star, Nathan Lee.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll give you the same advice that I was given when I was a kid. The siren's call, if you will, of pop music is that you can make a lot of money in a hurry if you follow the formulas that your record company will want you to follow. But what people really are after is somebody to say something fresh and somebody to come up with something new. So if you can avoid the temptation of imitation and try to dig in deep and find out where you are and what kind of song you're dying to write and what comes out of you as an individual, then you create your own marketplace and then everybody imitates you.
Don't bother if your motivation is to drive a Jaguar or if your motivation is bling or to be famous or for everybody to like give you the best table in the restaurant. Those are things that happen with success that are awesome. They're great little gifts, but it's the icing, it's not the cake. You have to do this because you're gonna die if you don't do it.
Well, this here is a song that I co-wrote with my friend Michael McDonald here on the piano. You missed some important moments that I'm gonna have to get even for now in the rest of the show. But this is a song, we've written about 5 or 6 songs together, Richard and I, and this was, I think, our second song we wrote together, and I think still the one I'm the most proud of. A song that I dedicate tonight to my son, Cody. And it's with his good graces that I perform this for you tonight. It's a song called The One That Got Away.
In life, a man can't learn to live without. And one of those things was you. Who the good guys are, who the bad guys are, isn't always clear. And in this world of separate houses, someone's always missing someone, day after day, and year after year. Oh, you and I are distant, don't ever think I do want you. You every day, no matter where life takes you, know that I'll still be waiting patiently for the day that you've forgiven me, my son, the one that got away. All of the little things that add up to life, and it's been so hard being outside looking in. You had hundreds of first times I didn't get to see, that will never come again. How do we catch up? is there just too much stolen history in this world of separate houses? I want you to remember that you'll always be inside of me. Though you and I are distant, don't ever think I didn't want you. I miss you every day. And no matter where life takes you, know that I'll still be waiting patiently for the day that you've forgiven me, my son, the one that got away. You carry in an anger that does not belong to you. I do believe in you and me, and I trust that someday you'll no longer be the one that got away.
From the minute I started writing this song, I just believed in my heart that it was really dumb. Like really lame and stupid. But there was something about this idea and this piece of music that kept kind of waking me up at night and pestering me in my subconscious to finish it. So I kind of had it sort of worked out, and I was trying to make up a little demo of it. This is a long time ago. And my wife, Cynthia, came to get me for dinner, and she said, "Whoa, what's that you're working on?" And I said, "Oh, it's this stupid song. It's about a girl in Nebraska that goes missing, and nobody knows what..." No.
Found her.
And there she is. And nobody knows what happened to her, and it's sort of like a little murder mystery. It's stupid. I'm certainly not going to put it on my album or anything like that. And my wife looked at me and she said, Oh no, that's only the coolest song you've ever written in your life. Don't go and do something crazy and put that on a record. So I was like, oh, okay. So I put it on the next album, thinking it would be this little album track that nobody really paid attention to. And as the album was out for a little while, my record company called up and said, "You know, we're getting a lot of response about this song." So they put it out as a single, and it became one of the biggest hits of my career, which is awesome. But it also means that my wife was right.
I bet she got something out of the deal.
Well, that kind of blows. Yeah. But I will do it for you. It's called Hazard.
My mother came to Hazard when I was just 7. Even then, the folks in town said with prejudiced eyes, "That boy's not right." 3 years ago, when I came to know Mary, first time someone looked beyond the rumors and the lies and saw the man inside.
We used to walk down by the river. She loved to watch the sun go down. We used to walk along the river and dream our way out of this town. For Mary, no one cared until the night she went out walking alone, and she never came home. The man with a badge came knocking next morning. Here was I, surrounded by a thousand fingers. Suddenly pointed right at me. But I swear I left her by the river. I swear I left her safe and sound. I need to make it to the river and leave this old Nebraska town. About my life gone by and how it's done me wrong. There's no escape for me this time. All of my rescues are gone, long gone.
Kevin Marks. On the guitar back there. Nice job, Kevin. Thank you very much.
My turn again, huh? This next song is it's a song off our new record, and in between the song that we played a minute ago, Away From the Sun, and this song was another song. It's called The Real Life. And Away From the Sun was all about being in the dark and in the real life, which we're not going to play, but it's kind of another chapter in those three songs, is kind of about finding a way to the light, you know, and at least seeing it, kind of searching for it. And this song is just about standing in the light. But it's also about how you can really easily get lost from yourself, trying to become things that other people want you to be. And also how you can keep yourself from being the person you want to be, but ultimately having to find yourself within yourself. And so appropriately, this song's called Let Me Be Myself.
guess I just got lost being someone else. I tried to kill the pain, but nothing ever helped. I left myself behind somewhere along the way, hoping to come back around to find myself someday. But lately I'm so tired of waiting for you to say that it's okay. Tell me, please, would you one time let me be myself so I can shine with my own light? Let me be myself. Would you let me be myself? 'Cause I'll never find my heart behind someone else. I'll never see the light of day living in this cell. It's time to make my way into the world I knew, and then take back all of these times that I gave in to you. And lately I'm so tired of waiting for you to say that it's okay. Tell me, please, would you one time let me be myself so I can shine with my own light? Let me be myself for a while, if you don't mind. Let me be myself so I can shine with my own light. Let me be myself. And that's all I've ever wanted from this world, is to let me be me. So please, would you one time let me be myself so I can shine with my own light? Let me be myself. Please, would you one time let me be myself so I can shine with my own light? Let me be myself for a while, if you don't mind. Let me be myself so I can shine with my own light. Let me be myself one time. Ooh, let me be myself and let me be me.
Thank you very much.